This video continues the discussion about the Konica Minolta controller for the AccurioPress color and black and white presses. In this video, I'm going to talk about the next two buttons on the top of the print driver. We're going to look at the layout and the finishing as some of the options select back and forth between the two of them, so they're a good thing to discuss together. So I'm going to go to the layout button first. And on the layout button, the first option of layout is two-sided. The checkbox in two-sided means that this is going to print as a duplex. I can also look along the side over here in my preview, and it shows me that this job is going to be duplexed. One of the other things this shows me is that it is currently going to print on letter size 8.5 by 11, and it's just going to output as a flat sheet. The next option that I've got is imposition. The most common imposition that someone is going to use is going to be booklet imposition. In this example, this imposition is going to take letter size sheets and do signature impositions into booklets, and by default it's going to put it on 11 by 17 or tabloid paper. You'll notice now my finishing folding has changed so that it shows this is going to be half folded and have two staples placed in it. That occurred just because I chose booklet, and if you don't want this to print and have it folded and stapled, if for example you were going to print this and take it to an offline fold and staple, you would then go to the finishing tab and you would have to turn off your multi-fold and the staple in that, and you can see that this now indicates that it's going to deliver as flat sheets. We'll go back and say we do want to do the multi half fold and two position staple just to continue with the booklet discussion. There's some other options below here for imposition quality, and the imposition quality is going to be a normal high precision and then a page interval. Page interval in some other drivers, you'll see this discussed as the gutter, and this is indicating the amount of space between the two pages that are put up on a sheet so that you can regulate how far apart these are spread. Zero in this case indicates that whatever the default position of this when it prints out is going to be correct. If you were doing something with something that had bleeds in it or something you needed to spread or push together, you could enter values into here. You've also got an option to allow for creep adjust, and then you can enter values in for that. So if you need the position relative to the sheet's position within the folded set chain so that you could perhaps maintain a margin for trim, then that would be where this would be entered into. You've got an option to say that I would like to do a booklet cover with a blank page. And this is just saying that I've already got a pre-printed sheet, that I'm going to insert that pre-printed sheet as my booklet cover. Next option is going to be booklet splitting. This is the number of pages per section. If, for example, you had a 800-page PDF file that what you actually wanted to print was 108-page booklets, then I could come to here and I could say that I'm doing an 8-page per section, and it would run 8 pages, and then it would do the staple finishing and deliver that out as 108-page books. There's an option here for book spread. I'll have a section of the video later on that's going to discuss some of the other options as far as the book spread, the full bleed, those types of things. So for now, I'm going to go back up and we'll look at the booklet. Change that to a 2-in-1, and if I come back over now and turn my finishing off, we can now see that 2-in-1 is just going to put 2 pages up, but it is no longer doing the booklet imposition. So I'm going to have page 1, page 2, page 3, page 4 on the back side of that, and it will work its way through that. I've got a 2 repeat, and the 2 repeat you see will give me basically a ability to print a book and then cut it and have 2 books printed up on a sheet. There are similar options for two up reversals where you can change the order. There's four up. So if you needed to have a different number of pages put up on a sheet, you could accomplish that with this. This is not a true imposition for these. You don't really have much control over how those lay out there. It's just going to evenly divide those across the page. But for a quick and dirty, I want to do two up letter on 11 by 17. It's perfectly functional for that. You'll see that I've got a couple of options down here towards the bottom for fit to page size and a custom zoom. So if I needed to scale this slightly to fit onto the paper better, I could do that. I've got an option to rotate 180. The rotate 180 doesn't show up on your layout and finishing, but basically what it does is it just rotates the images as it prints them 180 degrees. This is useful if you've got a stock that you have to put into the paper feed trays in a specific direction in order for it to feed properly, and then that places your document at the incorrect orientation on that sheet. This allows you to rotate that sheet. So for example, you were putting a hole punch paper or something like that in there, you could orient the print so that it would print properly on the job. You've also got selections here for the paper size of the original, the orientation of the original, and the paper size that you would like to print it out on. So I could, for example, say that I'd like to print this letter coming in and tabloid going out. If I did a fit to page size, it would actually do the enlargement to coordinate those so that it would fit to page. The next thing I'm going to look at is to go to the finishing tab. Obviously, the finishing tab is going to vary by the machine that it's connected to, because different machines are going to have different finishing options that are included. On this particular machine, I've got a small booklet maker, I've got a GBC punch unit, and a staple finisher. So the options are built to match up with what that capability is. You'll see that the choice I've got here for binding position tells me if I'm doing a two-sided document, which way those pages are going to flip. If I'm going to put a staple in there, I've got the option for a corner staple or two staples along the side, and how far apart those staples are. So you can see that the staple position moves a little bit as I go from narrow to wide. I've once again got an option to divide output. So if I had an 800 page document, I wanted to put a staple in every four sheets, I could select that I want pages per section to be four. It would divide those out, and then it's going to put staples, as I've selected up here, to go into each one of those four page sections. Got an option to turn punch on and off. I've got an option for folding. Depending on which accessories you've got installed on your machine, your folding options may differ. In this case, I've got a multi-half fold, a multi-trifold. You may have a half fold and a trifold. You may also have some other gate folds and Z folds and those types of options. My machine is not configured with those options, so I don't show them here. Before, we had seen when we were doing the booklets, I was using the two staples for fold and staple. You'll see if I turn that on, it automatically selects multi-half fold, and it will come back and show me that it's going to fold. One of the uses that you would put this for, you'll notice that it's going to make a booklet out of flat sheets. If you had a document that already had been imposed into booklets so that you didn't need to have the imposition done by the print driver, you would leave your imposition off, set your document to print two-sided, and then come in here and do a multi-half fold and two-position staples, and you could make booklets out of jobs that had already been imposed. If I look at the output tray, default in most cases just going to output the paper to whatever your machine's default is. Depending on the configuration of your finishers, you may have differing trays that you can send it out to. In this case, I can select to go out the stapler main tray, the stapler sub tray, which is the little tray on top of the finisher, and the relay unit sub tray, because my particular machine has a relay unit attached to it. Feed direction, most of the time you don't have to worry about feed direction. Long edge and short edge is going to be chosen for you automatically. You can set up your output order. The default in the driver is that it will print face down, and it will print the first page first. So what's going to go onto the tray is page one, and it's going to follow through in collated sets. If you would like to deliver that face up, you would do that. You can also then say, I'd like to deliver the last page first and have the first page on top. So you can deliver face up collated sets if you so desire. You've got an option here for sort and group, and then you've also got an option here for offset stacking. You can either offset by the number of sheets that are printed out or by the number of copies of a job you're printed out. So for example, if you are printing 1,000 pages and you would like to offset every 50 so that you could have groups of 50, that would be a use you could put that to. Now I want to take a few minutes to cover some of the advanced settings under booklet making for the IC-605 print controller. We'll start out with a book here that you can see is named Bleed Book Test. These are basically 9 by 11 and a half inch sheets. I've got an eighth of an inch of bleed around there, and this black box in the center of the sheet just represents what the 8.5 by 11 finished page size is that I would like to have. So if I start by coming into print, go into my printer settings. Once those settings come up, if I start by looking at what paper I'm going to use, I'm going to say that I want a 12 by 18 gloss text paper. On my finishing, you will see here that it's selected for multi half fold in two positions. That is because I've got my layout set for booklet. And you can see here that it shows that I'm going to be imposing this into spreads for a booklet and that I'm using a 12 by 18 paper and it's set to fold and staple. If I were just to say, okay, I would like to apply these settings and print that booklet, what I'm going to see is the result that looks similar to this. So I've got one sheet, I've got the other sheet, and I'll see that I've got the full image printed and a nice white gap between these pages because it is printing my whites from around this page that you can see here onto those sheets. So the first thing that I've got is I can come down to my page interval and I can say that I would like to do minus 0.5 inches. If I were to apply that and print it out, the result is now going to be, we'll see that the minus half inch is basically pulled those sheets together, but that I have still a white gap between these. And for these settings, that is the expected result. The next option that I can do, we'll see, is the high precision. When I come to high precision, I do my minus half inch page interval. Remember, this page interval is similar to the gutter adjustment on some other booklet settings that you might make. I now have the option to come down and put a checkbox in full bleed. Once I have that full bleed setting, if I were to print that page out, my result now is that it prints with a full bleed. I get my pages butted together properly and they would bleed across so that when I print that book out, I get a full bleed booklet that I can trim and have my pages cross over properly. Another feature of booklet printing on the IC-605 is a feature called book spreads. So you can see from this PDF file that I've got opened up, letter size pages within this document and a couple of 11 by 17 pages that have been placed into this document. What I'd like to have as a result is a front cover. This 11 by 17 spread across the inside from page 2 to page 3 in that document, then have this number 3 and number 4 page followed by this 11 by 17 spread across the centerfold of the booklet and then the following pages. In order to do that, I will come into my print settings. Once in the print settings, I will go to layout. Within layout, you can see that in this case, I've already told it that I want to have a booklet. We can see here that this is going to do a normal booklet on 11 by 17. I've got an option here for booklet spread. I'll put a check in the booklet spread, and now I would go ahead and print this book. So I can click OK and OK my way back out to print. So what does that accomplish? If I look in the user manual for the 3070, 3080, and I look under the printing section of it for the IC-605, one of the things that I can do in the finishing is the booklet spread that we talked about. If I click on Overview for Booklet Spreading, it gives me a pop-up that shows me that I've got letter-sized pages with some 11 by 17s inserted, and it's going to take those and lay those out and spread my pages across the facing letter-sized pages where they belong. Beginning from here, we can see the result of printing the booklet. We've got the front cover. As we open that up, we'll see our 11 by 17 spread across the two pages internal to the booklet. Then we can see that the next two letter size pages are printed properly, followed by the 11 by 17 printed across the centerfold of the book, and the following letter pages to complete the book out. And that is our result.